I actually just noticed that this year is the first year in 10 years that I was not bogged down, sad, moping around, depressed because my father passed. He passed February 18th, 2007, and it's been 10 years. And I'm going to say that probably I wasn't bogged down because I was dealing with other stuff. But even when I realized it was my father's birthday, March 25th, which was Sunday, I did acknowledge it, but I was okay. And you know it's bad when your teenager has to kind of remind you, not bad, I mean it's a good thing. I'm glad that my son is very spiritually aware, very spiritually mature for his age. I always say he's only 15 on paper. He's about to be the big sweet 16. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with him. He's going out of town again, but I want to do something like different for him, so I don't know, just had an epiphany, like I feel better, I'm not bogged down about like anything at this juncture, which is kind of huge. I've been seeing like a lot of online videos where I think women, I mean, I know there's more women than men, but we even dominate online. It's just different videos that kind of pop up because I don't go looking for them. But you know, like when you're on YouTube and you know, different things pop up. And then if people, they use certain titles, I guess, like for clickbait or whatever. I don't care what the title is. Most of the time, I put like the date, or I'll put like my son or proud mom, because again, I'm not on YouTube for all of that. This is like my releasing board slash something never happened to me. Jerk can go on YouTube and be like, oh, I remember when me and my mom did that. Ha 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 ha. He'll always have me. Hi, Jared. Hi, honey. How are you? Mommy loves you. My mommy is so proud of you. So mommy proud. You are such a yummy son to me. Yummy, yummy, yummy. In all facets, you just are amazing. That's all. But a lot of women are like making, I call them hate videos, you know, about ex-boyfriends, ex-husbands, and it's one thing to, you know, if you want to share your story, it's your right. If you were a part of a relationship, whether it's kids or, but just be mindful of what you share and how much you share. I've shared different things about parenthood, with Jared's, about, with and about Jared's father, but I wasn't like calling him names and slamming him. I think people think they're getting slammed if, you know, the information is accurate. Maybe they'll take it that way. Oh, can I park here? I am going to park here. Yes, I am. Just like them. I'm going to park here. Amen. So yeah, I think if the information is accurate, then people take offense. But even if it's accurate, still be mindful what you post. Share to edify and to help someone else, not to just like vent or anything like that. But back to my point, a lot of women have been putting up these hate videos, and I'm just like, I'm so grateful that I'm not a part of that fault, you know, not dogging them, not slamming them, because I'm a woman, and evidently I feel whether it's a male, female, they pose, people pose hateful things because they're hurt, you know, but it's just been a lot of that lately. I mean, like, a lot, and I don't know, I guess, like, in the day of freedom and freedom of expression and Donald Trump saying whatever he wants, and I guess everyone else is just like, okay. But I guess my point is, stop, you know. Think before you post. Even if, like, I'll sit and do a video, okay? And if my spirit is jacked up, before I post, I always, like, go back and, like, skim my videos. And it's like, oh, okay. And then I'll post. Some that's like, maybe that's a little too harsh. Or maybe you shouldn't say that. Or maybe you should reword it. Or if it's too much editing I have to do, I'll just delete it and be like, okay, I'll come back the next day. But there is just way too many negative videos just online in general. We all know that. But today, mostly, as I was observing, there was a lot of videos by women, and of course it pinched me because I'm a woman. So just trying to put that energy out there, as far as if you're hurt, you're upset, don't do a video. Like, if you're sharing, because I remember when I would see videos like, not videos, movies, I would go see, like, The Butler, The Help, things like that. I would go talk to my mom about her air when she grew up, and, you know, I would cry. So I would do videos like that. Like, I just talked to my mom and she shared some things with me from her past and when she was growing up and she was a little girl, and this is the reason why she never wants to go see historical movies like that, because she told me she lived it. And, you know, so I'm crying and sharing like that, but not just blatantly just being spiteful. Because what my father used to tell me, even if the other person, cat, dog, male, female, even if the other person is at fault, but you do something to feel like you're rectifying yourself, yes, people will look at the individual like, wow, why would you do that? But at the end of the day, they'll look at you like, why did he do that? Or why did she do that? Why would she post that? So keep that in mind, people. You know, God is the best person who can and who will have your back. Vengeance is the Lord's, you know. Yes, it don't feel good. And sometimes you do want to be like, I'm going to handle this. I know how I can fix this situation. But at the end of the day, is it worth it? And as you're growing in Christ, and even if you take Jesus out of the equation for a moment, because for me, he's a part of every equation. But even if you weren't a follower of Christ, just as a mature man and woman, like, what is it edifying? So I said all that to say, just think before you do things. It's not worth it. And you never know. Some of these people that you may post about, they have kids, and it's like, I get it. You want to prove a point, but people who have kids who are of age and they can, like, look up things, and you don't want to do that. You don't. Matter of fact, my son used to look up things about his dad, which I didn't even really know he was doing all of that. But he would come to me and be like, Mom, oh my gosh, look at this, you know. And I would just have to tell him, like, you know, stop looking at that stuff. You know, when you see the stuff, whether it's true or not, say a prayer for your dad if it is true, and then say a prayer for the person who's posting the stuff. Because evidently, whether there's truth to it or not, it was posted out of anger. So be the better person, naturally and spiritually. Be the better person, even when the person don't even realize you're praying for them. Because that's what real ministry is, when people do things when you don't even know that they're doing it. You know, a lot of people get prayed into their decision to follow Christ. You know, we all didn't wake up running for the Lord and on fire for Christ. So it's just time for everyone to grow up, do better, and God isn't soon to come. I believe he's here, and we just can't really feel the manifestation of his presence the way that we think we would. But I think he's just on the edge, like, any day now, seriously. So get your life right. It's not even worth it. Life isn't too short. Life is just short. So alrighty, happy Tuesday. God bless you guys. Bye.